My name is James Fung, and I work at the Advanced Technologies and Projects Group at Google. This is a really interesting opportunity for us to take the work of Project Tango and put it in a really unique environment that's difficult to recreate here on Earth.
My name is Joel Hesch. I work on Project Tango doing sensor fusion. What's really exciting about the collaboration with the NASA Ames team is to see how our prototype device can be paired with the science and sensing capabilities of SPHERES.
The primary purpose of SPHERES is really to do chores that astronauts have to do currently, but using robots to do those instead.
By adding on this cell phone that has the ability to visually navigate where it is and determine by its camera alone, we open up the platform to navigate the whole station.
Think about having a free-flying robot that can fly around inside a space station, perhaps equipped with some future smartphone.
We're going to do a zero-G flight in Texas.
What this zero-G flight is going to let us do is test all of the systems as they would operate in space in zero-G. Simulation doesn't work. We've got to fly it.
To see sensor fusion working in zero-G, I think that'd be pretty awesome. NASA had this whole health disclaimer. It was a little intimidating, but I think we'll be all right.
This aerobatic maneuver
can induce physiological responses
not generally experienced outside of this environment.
Hypoxia is a potential response. What's hypoxia?
Air hunger, I'm not sure what that is.
Apprehension, nausea,
headache, belligerence.
We have teams going up in groups of three. We have a test director, someone operating a laptop receiver, and we also have someone who's just operating the spheres. One of the responsibilities is to make sure that we run through the tests in the correct sequence and helping the other two guys keep on track.
Nowhere else can you do aerobatic maneuvers over and over again in a commercial airplane. On a standard flight, takeoff, nose up maybe 6 to 10 degrees, reach your cruise altitude, then you descend and land. On this flight, we take off, climb up to 19,000 feet, pull 1.8 Gs up to 35,000, and then descend at 26,000 feet a minute back down to our 19,000 feet.
It's pretty exciting. It's a wild ride.
To get to the zero-G sweet spot, we have the sweet spot indicators to be our accelerometers and also the duck.
Once the duck is right here, we've hit the sweet spot.
But the first couple, I was like trying to hold the sphere, trying to grab on.
Since we have SPHERES core converging, this will be a good test.
The development that we're doing is just getting started. And this is the first device that we're building. If you can do sensor fusion and perception on a mobile phone, you can enable so many use cases that can be used on other devices like SPHERES that benefit the lives of people and can really impact in a way that wasn't possible before. Both in terms of the opportunity to work on this project and for this particular collaboration, I think they're extremely unique opportunities.